you had an awesome performance against Smith. Triple G, you did great against Kell Brook. So now I think it's time for you guys just to meet up already and get over with.
And what happens when they meet up? What do you think would happen, Brandon? If you were a betting man.
What's going to happen when they meet up?
Yeah.
Let's hear a great fight. Let's hear a great fight.
Ricky says he likes Triple G.
I like Triple G too. I think Triple G stops him, but it'll be a great exciting fight though while it lasts.
If Canelo wins, would you be shocked? Would you be surprised?
No, I'll give Canelo his fucking props. He's legit.
Well, some people who watched the Kell Brook Triple G fight said if it was Canelo landing those punches, it would be a different story.
It could. Who knows?
But then again, if you watch the Smith Canelo fight, if it was Triple G landing those shots, not Liam Smith, it would be a different story.
That's true, but if you fucking. Canelo got great body shots. He got a great fucking body shot.
Those hurt.
Yeah, they fucking hurt. And Canelo got a great fucking body shot. And his combination, when he puts them, they look so smooth and easy going. You know? They look really smooth. Like they come together really smooth.
So what weight should that fight? What weight should that fight be at, Brandon? What weight? 154, 160?
Be at his weight class. Once he won the title at 160, right? So it should be at the 160 weight.
160? Canelo Triple G?
I say 154.
154?
I say 160.
That gives Canelo an advantage, 154, right?
Well, of course. I mean, who really wants to fight? Who really needs it? I want to know that.
Who needs to fight more?
Who wants to fight more? Who really needs it more?
Well, Canelo sold out 51,000 seats.
Canelo doesn't need it. Triple G is the one who really was going after him. Who started calling out who?
But Canelo sold 51,000 seats.
That's crazy.
Never mind.
That's crazy.
And what does he got? Triple G then sold a fucking like 51, but over there.
51,000 in England?
Triple G's been selling out a lot and mostly really? All the arenas. Yeah.
I think that arena they sold like 50-something thousand seats or something like that.
That's impressive.
I don't know.
Okay, if Canelo fights in Mexico.
That's out of fucking state. You know, Triple G, Canelo sold in state.
That's hard.
That's
in Texas, but Texas have good boxing. You always told me.
That's fucking, you know, selling 51,000 seats in Texas and the United States is kind of hard. Going outside of the country is easier because people want to see.
They have less entertainment. They don't have the Lakers, they don't have the Dodgers, they don't have. Celebrities like Angelina. Did you know that Ricky Funes trained Brad Pitt back in the day?
I see the picture.
Joe trained him. Not
oh, Joe, but what did you do? I saw you had a mustache.
I was a spectator.
Were you sparring him?
Actually, Ricky was kind of skinny. I was looking at him.
I was at 135.
I was like, little motherfucker, you're still fighting, huh?
135.
135? What do you weigh now? 140?
180.
I got videos of Brad Pitt fucked up in sparring.
Yeah, right. That would never happen. I would have leaked that out a long time ago.
They showed me videos that Brad Pitt fucked him up in sparring.
Hey, that would have been a straight lawsuit right there.
Why? Sparring? It's not a lawsuit. Yeah. You signed
you
a waiver.
Me, I'm going to sue your ass.
I don't give a fuck. Sue me for what?
Really?
Like the jerky boy is.
Really?
Sue everybody.
You're going to sue me for what?
Sue everybody.
What are you going to sue me for?
Your R8, the Audi.